Scorpio, welcome to your love reading for the first week of June. This is for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Since this is a love reading, I do recommend checking your Moon and Venus signs as well, as they may resonate better for you in a love reading than your Sun sign. As always, this isn't going to resonate for every Scorpio out there. We're not all living the same lives. If it doesn't resonate, just check your other signs or check out one of the other awesome readers on here. All right, guys, so for me as a reader, the overall energy, which just fell out, is always the person that I'm reading for. All right, that could be you, Scorpio, or it could be you, Cross Watcher. It's just going to be whoever's watching this video right now. That would be the energy that yourself are taking on this week in love. Everything else in the reading is interchangeable. It can be for you, the person you're dealing with, your surrounding energies. All right, recent past. I will show you what these are then. Once I get them set up, present energy for Scorpio in love. Immediate future for Scorpio. Potential obstacle. Spitting them out. Thanks, guys. Advice for Scorpio. Okay, here we go. So your overall energy, guys. You have the King of Wands reversed. So you guys are feeling really unmotivated, probably lacking some confidence, not feeling like your best self. Make sure you're not being controlling and demanding, guys. All right, let's see why you're all King of Wands reversed right now. Clarify the King of Wands reversed for Scorpio. Page of Pentacles. Okay, so here's the thing. There's this new offer, right? Somebody that you want to talk to, or somebody wants to talk to you, right? This is the beginning. It is meant to be a stable offer, right? It is meant to go in the direction of something long term, but it's like you feel like you're not good enough for it. With the King of Wands reversed here, it's like there's this offer, but you don't feel like you don't feel like you have the energy for it. You're not confident enough to accept the offer or to offer anything to anyone else. You're just not feeling yourself right now. Not sure why that is, guys. Do some self-care or something if you need to. Whatever it is that you need to do to get your confidence back, do that, okay? All right, your recent past, the Six of Swords. So this is air energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Let me see if I can switch this light because it makes these particular cards really bright. And then you can't see them and they're so pretty. All right, Six of Swords. So this is leaving a situation that was difficult, challenging, one where there were a lot of lessons, a lot of tests, and somebody's leaving them all behind. It is definitely breakup type energy. Doesn't have to be though, but if you didn't recently break up with someone, then the relationship has changed. Like you're leaving the difficulties behind. I don't think that's what it is for you. I think that you're actually, it was actually breakup energy or the feeling of needing to break up. Do you know what I mean? Because somebody here left something behind because it was too difficult, and you yourself are in this really crappy energy where you just, you don't feel like yourself. You don't feel like you can take on any new offers. You don't feel like you can offer anyone anything. It's like you have nothing to offer. It's like you have no self-confidence right now. Maybe because somebody walked away from you because it was difficult. You know, I'm not sure, but there's a reason. There's a reason that you're feeling that way. So let's figure it out. Your present energy. You have the Hangman. Pisces energy. So the Hangman is just trying to look at the situation from every angle, trying to gain a new perspective, gain some enlightenment on the situation. It's kind of like Hermit energy, except you're not closed off, right? It's not like you're isolating yourself. You're just not taking any action right now. You're trying to just observe the situation first before you figure out what you're going to do about it. And it may be because you don't have the energy right now and you're just kind of feeling down about yourself. So you're just going to kind of hang out and watch it and see what happens and get your energy back, right? All right, let's see here. And this could be the other person right now as well. If you're waiting on someone to take some action, and know that they're just kind of watching the situation right now. They're not in that mode. Clarify the Hangman for Scorpio. The Ace of Wands, Fire, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. That is a new beginning, right? It is like a new passionate beginning. So you yourself are not feeling the passion right now. You're like out of sorts, no energy, no drive, whatever. But somebody here is feeling the opposite. This is very sexual energy too, guys, FYI. Somebody here wants this new passionate beginning, and the other person is just kind of not taking any action. So it's like you guys are not on the same page, you and the other person that you're dealing with. Somebody wants a new beginning. The other person is not moving on anything, and that would be you, right? King of Wands is that type of person. All right, let's see what your future is, guys. Queen of Pentacles reverse. A more breakup energy, very non-committal. This is Earth, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. It's not loyal energy, it's materialistic, it's selfish. So, I mean, if I was dealing with that kind of person, I wouldn't want to act on it either. So, all right. Clarify the Queen of Pentacles reverse for Scorpio in the future. Page of Cups. So there's another offer. You've got two offers here. It could be the same person, could be a couple different people that want to talk to you, but in the future, you have this new offer again, right? It is an emotional offer, whereas the Page of Pentacles is more commitment-minded, stability-minded. This is emotional. It's water, so you guys as well as Cancer and Pisces, and it's new, it's younger. Doesn't mean it has to be a younger person, but it is newer energy. But it doesn't look like there's commitment with it, or you don't want there to be. Could also be an apology from someone that you have already broken up with this Queen of Pentacles reversed here. All right. What are you hoping for, Scorpio? The Five of Wands reverse, fire energy, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. So you're hoping for an end to the drama. You don't want the drama, you don't want the arguing, the petty back and forth, the competition, the jealousy, whatever it is in your world. You don't want the drama, right? All right. You know what? I totally missed. Actually, I'm going to do this different because I don't feel like reading your advice yet. We'll do that at the end, okay? Obstacle. Potential obstacle for Scorpio. Two of Cups. Somebody might already be in a connection. Somebody might already be connected to another soulmate. Or you guys just need to balance out your connection. All right. That is water energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. So here's the thing. With looking at the rest of your reading here and the Two of Cups being your potential obstacle, you have the Queen of Pentacles reversed in your future. Okay. So it could be that you're waiting for someone to get out of a relationship, and that's the obstacle. They're already connected to somebody else. Or maybe you are. Maybe you're connected to someone you don't want to be connected to, and that's why the Queen of Pentacles is reversed in the future, because it's a very non-committal, not loyal energy. Okay? I'm going to clarify that one. Why the Two of Cups as an obstacle for Scorpio? Why the Two of Cups as an obstacle for Scorpio? The Tower reversed. Mars energy, so yours as well as Aries. All right. So the Tower reverse here. Somebody's trying to avoid a disaster. Somebody is trying to avoid this connection falling apart, right? Whether it's you or them, there's something going on here that doesn't involve just two people. Okay? Whether it's known or not known, or even like an active thing or whatever, it's there, it exists. You don't have a soulmate relationship as an obstacle unless it's not with you. Does that make sense? Because this isn't an obstacle card. This is a card that you want to have in a relationship, but if it's your obstacle, it would be because the other person is already connected to someone else, or you are. And there's this, trying to hold on to that, trying to avoid this disaster. Maybe somebody's not wanting it to come out. Oh, man. This is a heavy one, guys. All right. What are you afraid of, Scorpio? What is Scorpio afraid of in love? What is Scorpio afraid of in love? Oh, wow. The Tower, again. Do you see what just happened here? The Tower reversed is your obstacle, and your fear is the Tower upright. So you're really trying to keep something from not falling apart. Hardcore. All right, let's see. What is this Tower now as your fear? Clarify the Tower for Scorpio. Again, this is your energy as well as Aries. And it's sudden change, it's disruption, it's chaos, it's foundations falling apart, obviously. Clarify the Tower for Scorpio as a fear. The Sun, what? Guys, the Sun is the happiest card in the deck. Why are you afraid of happiness? Huh? What is the deal, Scorpio? I don't think that's what it is, honestly. I think that you're afraid of, there's things that are hidden, right? When the Sun comes out, everything is shown. There's clarity. You're afraid of that clarity because you think that it's going to cause everything to come crashing down and fall the hell apart. That's what needs to happen, though. If there's anything that is hidden and it coming out would cause your situation, relationship, whatever it is for you to fall apart, then it should fall apart, right? Because it's not built on anything sound and stable. So yeah, change is scary. We're fixed signs. We don't like change, but the Tower is Scorpio energy. So you can handle it. Let it all come out and transform it. That's your job. That's what you should be doing, right? Okay. Your advice. The Queen of Wands, and you have the King of Wands reversed as your energy. So the goal is to flip that upright and be in this Queen of Wands energy, right? Get your confidence back. Go after what you want, right? Be yourself. Whatever it is that you need to do to look at yourself and think that you're hot shit, that's what you should be doing, right? That's the Queen of Wands energy. She's like the life of the party, super attractive. You're not feeling that right now as far as yourself. You need to be, all right? Let's clarify the Queen of Wands as advice for Scorpio. Nine of Pentacles reversed. Watch out for codependency. All right, make sure you aren't engaging in any codependent behavior and make sure the other person isn't. With you having this tower energy here twice. If you're in a relationship, this sucks. You know, you do have the Six of Swords here, so there are challenges. If you're in a relationship that sucks and you're going to continue to be in it, it's going to make you King of Wands reverse. It's going to make you feel like shit about yourself, and it's going to become codependent. That's why the Tower comes in. Do you get it? Like, if you're not willing to change something yourself that is not healthy for you, then the universe is going to come and knock it down. And you can try to avoid it all you want, but it's going to happen because the sun's going to come out. Whatever is unseen is going to be seen, and it's going to fall apart because it has to, because it's not built on a good foundation. And when it's not built on a good foundation and shit is toxic and it sucks, it drains you. So it has to stop. You can't go on like that forever. You're just going to be in this codependent mess. So get back to yourself. Do whatever it is that you need to do to get back to your stealth. Word of the day. Get back to yourself. You know, start feeling yourself. Whatever it is that you need to do. I don't know. I like photo shoots. Do a photo shoot. Take a walk in the woods. I don't know. Get yourself together. So that you can go after what you want and not be so terrified of something falling apart that isn't good for you anyway. Know what I mean, Jelly Bean? Okay, take care, Scorpio.